California is recognized.
Madam Speaker, in California, we are often inundated with reports of the impact of climate change, overfishing, wildfires, and droughts. Such reports may frighten or dampen a child's innate curiosity and wonder of the natural environment. Fortunately, we have found that connecting children to their environment through hands-on experiences offers an effective way to overcome these challenges. Over the past 7 years, two NOAA education programs, the Bay Watershed Education and Training Region Program, or as it's known, BWET, and the Environmental Literacy Grants, or ELG program, have been critical tools in advancing a nationwide strategy of experiential education in building ocean, atmospheric, and environmental awareness in the United States. In my district, the MERITO program, which has been funded through the California BWET program for the past 4 years, has allowed hundreds of children to enjoy the benefits of hands-on, bilingual ocean conservation experiences with trained scientists and professionals in Santa Barbara. Many of these children have taken their first trips to the beach under this MERITO program, even though they may live only a few miles away. According to the testimonials from their parents and their teachers, it has given many of them a new awareness of their local environment and their community, and have opened a world of new opportunities that they now know they can pursue. Madam Speaker, my bill, H.R. 3644, seeks to formally authorize these two innovative and important NOAA education programs that were established through the annual appropriation process so that we can ensure that they are here for our children now and in the future. It also ensures that certain standards and criteria for implementation are met by the agency when they spend these funds. To me, this represents a responsible oversight effort on the part of our committee to exercise our proper duties. Madam Speaker, these programs have been well received by the ocean and environmental literacy communities, and in fact, since the ELG program was initiated in 2005, the demand for ELG grants has been 10 times greater than the available funding. Each program has gathered significant momentum and prominence since the Congress passed the America Competes Act in 2007, which elevated and enhanced NOAA's educational mission. A recent report released by the National Academy of Sciences also commends both programs for their positive contributions to increase student interest in science and to improve awareness of the ocean and coastal environment. H.R. 3644 is fully supported by the administration. The legislation is also strongly supported by the Campaign for Environmental Literacy. And this is a coalition of nearly 60 national, regional, and local private nonprofit organizations, and they represent science, education, conservation, outdoor recreation, and zoological parks, including the National Wildlife Federation, America's Fisheries Society, the American Fly Fishing Trade Association, and the Association of Zoos and Aquariums, to name just a few. At the appropriate time, I will offer an amendment in the nature of a substitute, which reflects a bipartisan compromise to address the concerns raised by my colleague and my friend, Congressman Cassidy of Louisiana, during the markup of this bill by the Committee on Natural Resources. Madam Speaker, in closing, the BWET and ELG programs are both effective, wildly popular, and in great demand by educators around the country. These programs represent two critical investments in our efforts to connect children to their natural world, and hopefully as a result inspire their interest in the sciences and in ensuring the future of their coastal communities. We should recognize their importance today by passing this legislation and codify them as formal programs within NOAA. Madam Speaker, I reserve the balance of my time.
The gentleman